Good day to you from ChemHelp ASAP. In this video, we will discuss different aspects of in vivo preclinical safety studies performed during drug discovery and preparation for clinical trials. By the end of this video, students will be able to describe how very early in vivo safety data are generated, list common animal species used in preclinical safety, define good laboratory practice, and describe timelines for general toxicology studies. The earliest in vivo testing of a compound normally focuses on efficacy, or the pharmacokinetics of a compound. Safety, however, may be monitored as well, especially in efficacy studies. While following disease progression in animal disease models, researchers will also look for early signs of toxicity. A common example would be to monitor liver enzyme levels, ALT and AST, periodically during an efficacy study, to also check on possible liver inflammation or damage because of the compound being tested. Likewise, upon completion of the study, histopathology studies on the animals will allow examination of organs for appearance and size, and even biopsy for detection of any damage or abnormalities. While these types of preliminary studies are very informative and useful, these studies do not replace formal preclinical safety testing to satisfy regulatory requirements in anticipation of starting human trials. General toxicology studies support the design and conduct of human trials. The animal species studied normally include one rodent and one non-rodent species. The rodent is typically either the mouse or rat, most often the rat. The non-rodent species is typically either the dog or monkey, also called NHP, non-human primate. Keep in mind that these studies are to help inform safety risks in humans, so the animal species in the studies are selected based on how closely relevant biological pathways align with humans. Of course, the biggest question is whether the animal species expresses an analogous target that is bound by the drug candidate in humans. The small number of common species may be surprising, but this small set means that the amount of data on each of these species is immense. So variations in safety outcomes can be interpreted with high confidence. The studies involve multiple groups of animals, with each group receiving multiple doses of different sizes to determine dose limits for safety. Key organ functions are also monitored. These studies also follow GLP guidelines, good laboratory practice. GLP focuses on assigning responsibilities and procedures that must be satisfied during the study. Both in vivo and in vitro studies can be performed under GLP. Following GLP guidance adds cost, but it improves the value of the data and is required by regulatory authorities. The length of GLP toxicology studies depends on the anticipated dosing period of the clinical compound. Some compounds are not dosed in patients for a long period. For example, a course of antibiotics may require just 10 days of medication. Compounds with a shorter dosing regimen undergo correspondingly short toxicology studies. The general rule of thumb is that GLP toxicology dosing must be performed for at least as long as human dosing in both the rodent and non-rodent studies. This rule holds until 6 months of human dosing. Beyond 6 months of dosing in humans, the rodent studies may be terminated at 6 months, but the non-rodent studies must be continued until 9 months. Note that many new drugs are chronic medications, such as drugs for high blood pressure or high cholesterol, and all these types of drugs require longer testing for general toxicology. Also, studies for developmental risks and carcinogenicity are separate from these general toxicology studies.
We have described the origins of in vivo safety data. We have listed the common preclinical species, mouse, rat, dog, and monkey. We have defined good laboratory practice, GLP, and described the timelines for general toxicology studies.
That was certainly a quick review of in vivo preclinical safety studies. If you enjoyed the video, please subscribe to the channel, make a comment, ask a question, or leave a like. Take care.